glad you're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. In case you're joining us for the first time, this show airs weekdays, Thursday at 10 p.m. here on Urban TV, and the repeat is on Saturdays at 8 in the morning. Plus, on our socials, you could follow the conversation as well here on Urban TV. Plus, below right your screen there, you can see the social handles. Let us know where you're watching from and what you think about the show. What is that thing that you're struggling with as a business person? You could have the experts here to talk to you about them. Yes, just to help you, you know, increase your sales on a daily. Plus also, is it financial struggles or whatnot? We can have the conversation on every given day. Talking given days, let's then talk you through how to make money this week. And how many times do you ever turn your hobby into real making of money? So most of us have what we love doing, but we've never for a moment, you know, stepped back and said, wait, if I actually decided to make money out of this thing, can it work? Now, that is one of the things someone is doing, and professionally, she is a doctor, but she loves cake making, and she just decided, you know what, all of a sudden, I'll do my profession, yes, I'll stay as a doctor, but as a hobby and passion, I will get into cake making. She is making some money. Just learn from her how to make money.
I am the proprietor of Cake Tubisha Uganda Limited, where we make cakes that we try to be different. That's like you beg to differ or you also cake to differ. Yes, I'm a medical doctor and I'm still practicing as a medical doctor. I work with the Vienna Virus Research Institute. I do vaccine research and I do baking as my business. And it's a passion that I've had, initially introduced to me by my sister, who is a baker and based in the UK. But she interested in me, and then I discovered that actually I had the skill, I have the talent, and so I'm just as creative. So I decided to do it as a business, and I try to do the best. So if you're looking for a cake that's different, a cake that's not the usual, a cake that is trendy, a cake that is, on the global market, you come to us at Cake Tubisha Uganda. We'll be able to provide you that. So don't speak and say, okay, this is just my profession. I'll only practice as a doctor. Have something else to do. Do other businesses. Look out for your passion. Look out for other skills that God gave you and practice it. And as you're making some money, you're also, getting yourself interested in more, and also you're impacting other people. You don't need only passion, you need the skill. So you need to train. You need to go and learn new things. I go online, I go to exhibitions. Even here, there are other bakers. I talk to other bakers. We have bakers groups where you learn new things. So you have to keep learning. So you have to remain a student. That's the first thing. You have to have the passion, of course, and then the skill. So you grow your skill even as you learn. And then hard work. Cake business is hard work, and there are many, many sleepless nights that we go through as bakers. So sometimes I come from my work, I've worked the whole day, and then in the night or in the evening I'm working. But I also have a very good team that I work with, so they help me along. So, but basically I'm the head of the business, and so I put in the work. Yeah, I also have my support from my sister, who's based in the UK, who also helps. Sometimes she comes, this expo, she didn't come, but usually she comes out and helps out. So yeah, there's a lot that goes into any business. It's just like any other business. You need to put in the work. You need to keep improving on yourself. The cakes that I brought here at the expo years back are different from the cakes that I'm doing now. And I hope they are better. I know they are better. So I keep improving on myself, on my skill. I go for training. You put in the money, you train yourself and also learn from others. So yeah, not only passion, but passion is a very good thing, but not only passion, hard work, just challenging yourself to get better. Because every day you go out, you see something, you say, oh my goodness, yeah. Even here at the expo, there are many other bakers who are doing great work. So we have learned from them, I've seen things they've done, new things that they are putting into the business. So yeah, you have to keep personal improvement. You have to keep on improving as you go along. There's nothing like a side hustle. Business is business. If you decide to do business, do business. So I have to put in place a system of how the money comes in, who receives it. I keep records. I do my finances. I have filed taxes. So it has to run like any other business. Otherwise, then it's just a hobby. And so you're not making any money. But if you want to make money, you have to run it as a proper business. So put in place everything, yeah. So some of the things, I mean, a work in progress. Right now I'm doing a course on entrepreneurship and financial management. And I know I'm going to get better, and I'm putting in place things, systems, and making sure that things run on systems, that they don't have to depend on a person, and they can cross-check. I have to do my taxes, I have to file them, I have to make sure that at the end of the year, of the day, I know what I've made, whether this is a profitable business or not. So it's not just a hobby. Otherwise, you can decide to make it as a hobby and then it doesn't matter. But it's not a hobby for me, it's a business, and I put in the work. I travel, I go to exhibitions, I go bring quality stuff from anywhere, from the UK mostly, and I make things work. So it's not just a hobby, it is a business, and I have to put in. So I have to know all those things. Obviously, it started out as a home business, but right now it is really professionalizing and really trying to make it investor ready and also scaling it to a bigger point. Yeah, we're growing, and I hope to get even better. We have a branch in the UK. Hopefully we'll have another one maybe in Canada, maybe in the US or wherever. So yeah, we would love to go global. So this is not a small time thing. So balancing, I have to work. I have my full-time job, but I also have I have a team that works after hours and while I'm away. And then I come in and join in after hours, but also on the weekends. Wow, yes, it's not, I didn't have any money to start. Actually, how this all started, one of my sisters, as I said, we have a branch in the UK. One of my sisters lives in the UK. So she's an accountant, but she also had a passion for baking. So because she wanted to stay home, take care of her kids, she decided to start doing baking at home so that she could be able to take care of her kids. So she made it, she professionalized the business, and as she started growing big, people used to hire her to pay for her to come from London to Uganda to make their wedding cakes. So she used to do that at some times. Then the times, we had some clients who couldn't afford to pay her. So she would say, okay, I can't come, but then I would do what? I'll tell you what to do. So she would be on the phone and tell us, do this, do that, and we would be, that's how we started. Because when she used to come, she would stay with me at my home, and that's, so I would observe and learn. So for those who couldn't afford to come, then I would just be the one to do that, baking. And with time, we used to consult her on everything, but as time went on, got better. And we started with my home kitchen. We used to do everything in the home kitchen. Then before I converted my garage into a bakery, I started getting one equipment after the other. So now I have a lot more equipment than I had in the beginning, but it has been one day at a time. Even now, I still need more stuff. I still need more equipment. I still need new machines, new things to work with. So I'm growing slowly but steadily. I've been coming to the Bride and Groom Expo from the very first time it started, 14 years ago. In fact, 10 years ago, we were given a medal for participating in the Bride and Groom Expo for 10 years. So that's really where we have come from. One day at a time, you get an order. I think the chance comes with where you get a chance to be given to make a cake for a wedding, for somebody. So for us, it was my sister's wedding. My sister did her own wedding cake. That's how it started. And then with time we started getting relatives and then friends and then coming to places like the expo. You get new clients and you make yourself better, and then you also attract good clients and profitable clients. And then it's really business. You have to put their marketing budget, you have to put their a sales budget. So you really need to work on whatever. First and foremost, you can do this if you believe in yourself. But as I said, you have to put in the work. So you're young, you've just come out of school, maybe you're looking to set up a business. Start where you are. Get a chance, maybe make birthdays for your friends, for your family, for your relatives. If you get a chance to make a wedding, give it your best. Look for the experts, look for, there's a lot of information even online on YouTube. You can learn a lot of things. Put in the work, teach yourself. If you get a chance to go for proper training, go and do the training and keep growing slowly and slowly. Come to an expo like this and find out and say, come and ask somebody like me and say, how did you start? What have been your challenges? There'll be challenges. There've been challenges. We've had times when, you know, cakes have gotten, you know, fallen down, for example, and you've got mistakes like those. You've got cakes when the client has not been happy with what you've done, or they've not paid up. Okay, so there's many challenges, but you surmount them one day at a time. So don't get discouraged. Just keep going. Keep trying. Start with that one cake, and then it will be two, and then it will be many more cakes. So with time, you'll get to, you know, we are not, I've not yet arrived. I've not got where I want to be. I'm still trying. That's why I'm here anyway. Otherwise, if I had already arrived, I would not be at the expo. But I'm here. I'm still trying to look out for clients, and I'm trying to get the best for them, as I also hope that I can get the best out of them. I have no plans of quitting my other profession because I can still run my business, whatever. Even the Bible says that we need to have 9 streams of income. So this is one of my other streams of income. And I'm so proud of it because I come to the expo like this, and things that I've thought about when I'm sleeping, when I'm just like, for example, this gown, I was just thinking about it the other day in my room. And now I bring it out, the concept comes out, and people come and look at it and they are impressed and they like it. That's very encouraging for me. Then I know that I'm putting my skills that God gave me to use. I'm impacting somebody. I'm inspiring somebody to also try out something. I didn't know that I could bake. I couldn't know that I could decorate, that I had even a creative mind until my sister challenged me to do it. And that's how I've been doing it. So that makes me proud. I mean, I want to get bigger. I have my kids part of my business, my children. My son is over there, he's on holiday, but he's busy helping out. So I like that I have something that my children can look at and say, okay, mom is working hard and can come and we know that we can also do this. So yeah, so that's really me. I'm proud of that. I really, there's a lot more that I want to do in this business. And I know that with God's help and the work that we put in, we'll go places, we'll be able to scale, we'll be able to grow.
You know, it's popularly said that you cannot sit on your talent, and sometimes it's hard for you to understand that it's a talent until you try it. So you might go the first time and make the mistake, and if you probably choose to step off, you might not then make the money or the breakthrough that you would have dreamt of on any given day. I hope you've learned something from the doctor professionally and now a cake, you know, person and making some money on the side. I keep saying it's important for you to have alternative businesses to make that money. If one particular one is not doing as much, you could just use the other money to support this one for the meantime until something kicks in. So you can see from her that even if, you know, her profession is not doing as well at a particular moment, she can just get some money and support the cake business. But remember, as I keep saying, if a second business that you're running does not make money, you should know at what point you should stop pumping money into that business. So you need to do your calculations well, see if it is going to make a breakthrough, let's say after 6 months, and if it's not, then you might want to decide whether you want to close it, or you can just put in a little more money to see how far the business can go. Okay. Let's talk you through personal finance tips for this week. And in the second episode of the month-long conversation on personal finance, we are talking alternatives for raising capital for new business ventures. Here is what you need to know in personal finance tips for this week.
Hi, good evening, viewers. Welcome to yet another episode of The Business Show. My name is Enoth Mbeine, your business coach. Last week, we looked at the various ways of raising funds, and we specifically looked at the personal sources of finance. This particular episode, we are going to look at other ways, and here we shall be looking at external borrowing or external debt. And external debt normally looks at equity and debt financing. And before we go further, we need to analyze what you need to consider, the various things you need to consider before going into acquiring an external debt or external capital, external finances. One, you need to determine precisely how much you need. Do you need 200 million? Do you need 300 million? Depending on your business. Then secondly, you need to determine the type of financing you need, which will be appropriate for your business. Is it short term? Is it long term? And then thirdly, it's very important that you develop a strategy on how you're going to acquire these finances. Is it going to be a business plan? Are you going to go out and talk to these potential investors and talk to them about your idea as a business? All this should be incorporated in your strategy. So what exactly is equity financing and debt financing? Equity financing is majorly looking at exchanging partial ownership of your business to a potential investor. So here your investor acquires a share or part ownership of your enterprise in exchange for the capital that he has given you. And debt financing is the usual one, which is walking into a commercial bank and acquiring a loan. Equity capital or equity funding majorly looks at three components, usually, which are common here in Uganda. We have the venture capital, and venture capitalists always look at organizations that have an exceptionally growth potential. That's when they will be attracted to put in their money. Then we also have what we call business angels. These are individuals who have put together money and they want to invest it. And they usually invest this for startups, especially when businesses are starting and when the idea is interesting. And then the other debt financing mechanism is using of initial public offers. For example, selling of stock to the public. You've seen and heard of companies like MTN when they sell their stocks. You've seen New Vision. We've also seen DFCU selling their stock or shares out there for people to invest in the capital, in the organization. When you look at debt financing, this mainly looks at commercial banks. Now, businesses out there, you need to know that debt financing is not a very good practical source of funding, because they usually want to fund an organization that has already been in existence. Commercial banks are very risk averse. They fear to invest in an organization or a business that has just started. What are they interested in? Usually, most of these commercial banks who give you these loans, they're interested in seeing how strong or good your cash flow is. Is it healthy? Is it positive? Then they also need to look at your audited finances. Do you have proper financial structures in place? This is what they're really interested in. Then also, good management. Is your organization or company being managed by professional and good principles and structures? That is of interest to commercial banks. And then of course, does your company or organization have a healthy balance sheet? That would, if it has a healthy, positive balance sheet, that would attract them. So ladies and gentlemen, tonight we've looked at equity and debt financing as sources of finance. I thank you.
So the alternatives don't necessarily have to be borrowing because, so one of the issues that startups struggle with is failure to access finances. And as a result, some of them will always look at loans as the sure way to get money to start. But it's important for you to look at the other alternatives. If there's any other alternative ventures that you can get into, or sources rather, to get money to support your new ventures, then you might want to go there instead of starting from the bank. I keep saying money from the bank is always available. They will ask you for all this collateral and whatnot, and you'll bring them the land title and whatnot, house titles and all that. But at the end of the day, if you're not able to break through in these unprecedented times, then you will question yourself on what must I do to have this money paid back. So you will take a loan that is probably payable in, let's say, 3-5 years, and then in the first 1 year, you're not able to pay because the business is not breaking even. That's why experts will tell you it's important for you to start your business with money that is saved rather than money that is borrowed from the banks. Let's talk the Forex and money market report. I am somehow impressed by the way fuel prices are dropping. You know, it's not as fast as you'd imagine, but look, 4990 is not too bad. We are looking at what was 6 something a couple of months ago, so it should be good enough. Plus, on the Forex market, the shilling has been at about what, 3.68-ish, depending on where you transact from. Let's have a comprehensive report now of the Forex and money markets. I keep saying if I was to choose any other profession, I would probably choose doing the business thing because it's just one of the things that I think I like the most. And for you that steps out every other day to try and make money, if it is something you're doing out of passion, then stay with it. But if you're doing it because your neighbors are somehow successful in business, you'll be disappointed because I keep saying business is not for the faint-hearted. There are times you go without making sales, but you have to meet the bills. Yeah, you have to keep going there to keep asking or hoping that clients can come through for you to make that money. So it is not for the faint-hearted, but you might have to just strategize, look at the things that your neighbors are not doing well, and it is probably from those small things that you will do to win your first and next clients to your business. I have to go now. That's all your time for the business show this week. Thank you so much for making time. Feel free to get in touch with us on our socials right below your screen, and in case you missed the main show, the repeat is on Saturdays at 8 in the morning. You take care of yourselves for me and the team. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.